Hello, a very good morning to all. I am Mr. S. S. Sazne from Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sharad Institute of Technology, Polytechnic. And I am teaching the subject management. From the last two lectures, we have started with the multiple choice questions from the second chapter, that is planning and organizing at supervisory level. And in today's lecture, we will continue with the remaining part of multiple choice questions and conclude the second chapter today itself. In this slide, we will continue with the MCQs. The next question is 26th one. In this question, we are having two statements. So the first statement is planning of material is the responsibility of supervisor, and the second statement is planning of manpower is the responsibility of HR manager and not of supervisor. And the options given are option A, only one is correct, option B, only two is correct, option C, both are correct, and option D, both are wrong. So if you read the question carefully, then out of these two statements, we are supposed to identify that whether both the given statements are correct or incorrect. So if we talk about the first statement, that is planning of material is the responsibility of supervisor, then you should know that since material is one of the resource, the supervisor has to perform the function of better utilization of this resource. So all the raw materials, supportive production materials, as well as accessory materials from useful component which are required for production, that is the responsibility of the supervisor. So we say that it is the responsibility of supervisor to plan for the material. Now if we talk about the second statement, which is planning of manpower is the responsibility of HR manager. So HR manager is none other than a human resource manager who are generally involved with recruitment or training, as well as career development, compensation and benefits. So these kinds of work are related with the human resource managers. Whenever there is a requirement of any manpower, then the actual role of these HR managers starts. So they will recruit the staff by preparing job descriptions and job advertisements, and then they will shortlist the applicants for an interview using a variety of selection techniques. So you also might have heard this regarding the placements that are carried out in our colleges also. So the same kind of task is performed by the HR managers. Now if we come back to our given question, then the second statement that is given, that planning of manpower is the responsibility of HR manager and not of the supervisor. So this statement will be wrong, because for the planning of manpower, again, manpower is also a resource, so it is the responsibility of supervisor for effective utilization of this manpower. Planning will be necessary and it will be definitely done by the supervisor. So the second statement will be wrong, and if we look at the given options, then only first statement is correct. So the answer for this question is option number A, that is only one is correct. Next is 27th question. Following qualities are not required in organizing skills of supervisor, and the options given are option A, planning, option B, decision making, option C, financial knowledge, and option D, time management. So to attempt this question, first you should know what is the meaning of organizing. So organizing is nothing but, we have already seen that, it is the activity of coordinating and directing the company's resources in such a way that they can be betterly utilized and the goals of the company can be achieved. So if we are supposed to utilize all the resources in the best possible way, then definitely there is some kind of planning requirement. So option A is necessary. If we see about the next option, that is option B, then decision making, which is nothing but a process of identifying the best alternative out of the available several options. So since in decision making process, as we are thinking a lot of all the available options and then selecting the one option which will be helping in best utilization of resources. So in organizing itself, we have seen that we are supposed to make a better or effective utilization of resources. And for this purpose, the decision making is an important tool or a parameter. So option second will be also correct. Again, if we talk about the last option, that is option D, time management, then we should know that without time management, neither organizing nor planning is possible. So time management is also necessary for organizing. Then the only left out option is the financial knowledge. So for organizing skills of the supervisor, there is no any requirement related with the finance. So the answer for this question is option C, that is financial knowledge. Next question, that is 28th one. When there is change in technology, then we have to answer what will happen. So the options given are option A, plan fails. Option B, plan has to be modified. Again, option C, plan must be rescheduled. And option D, all of the above. So this question is again related with planning, and up till now we have seen a lot of concepts related to planning. So I think that you might be able to answer this question very easily. As we know that planning is one such thing which is usually predicted for the future. So no one can assure regarding whatever the plan has been decided that will surely going to happen in the future. So whenever there will be change in technology, then the plan will fail, and whenever the plan fails, then the supervisor has to modify the same, or also he might have option regarding rescheduling of this plan. So whatever the options that are given, all those options are correct, and the answer for this question is option D, that is all of the above. Now again, the next question, that is 29th one. When emergency situation comes, what is going to happen? We have to answer. So the options given are as follows. Option A is continue previous planning. Option B, change the situation. Option C, change the plan. And option D, none of the above. So many times in the industry, there are possibilities that some unexpected accidents might occur, which can be related with emergency situations. So such kind of emergency situations are unfortunate or unexpected and unintentional, and they typically result in the damage of most of the resources, and finally it causes a loss to the company or industry. As we know that no one can predict these emergency situations in advance. So it is the responsibility of the supervisor to be prepared for such situations. And also a good supervisor will always have plan B in case if such kind of emergency situation occurs. Thus, for the given question, if we look at the given options, then option A, that is continue previous planning, then it is not at all possible. The second option, change the situation, then immediately it is not possible to change whatever the situation has arisen. But option C, that is change the plan, this will be the best option for the supervisor. As we have already discussed, that the supervisor, a good supervisor, will always have plan B for such kind of situations. So the answer for this question is option C. Now the next question is planning by supervisor is dash. So again we are having four statements here. That is an interdependent process. Statement 2 is a continuous process. Again integration of various activities. And fourth statement is looking into the past. And the options given are as follows. Option A is 1 and 2 are correct. Option B, 2 and 3 are correct. Option C, 1, 2 and 3 are correct. And option D, 2, 3 and 4 are correct. So just we have to see in the question whether whatever the four statements related with planning that are given, those are correct or not. And accordingly, we have to then look into the options for the correct answer. So whatever the statements that are given in this question, we know that all those statements are related with the characteristics of planning. And I hope that you might be remembering related with this point, because we have spent an entire one lecture for understanding this concept of characteristics of planning. If we look at the first statement, that is interdependent process, then yes, we have studied this, that the activities of any industry or company, they are divided into many departments, such as production department or purchase, as well as a finance department or HR department. So all the departments have their own separate plans, and these plans are also part of some master plan. So all these departments are interdependent on each other. So we can say that planning is an interdependent process. Then again, the second statement, that is planning is continuous process. Then again, this also option is true, because the process of planning continues as long as the organization or company continues to exist. So the supervisor always starts planning before the work is started, and when the work is complete, then again he has to start planning for the new project. The third statement, that is the integration of various activities. So integration is basically nothing but the process of joining or mixing different groups of people or machineries for carrying out a specific task and making the plan successful. Now the last statement, that is looking into the past. So we have not studied such type of any characteristics related to the planning. So this option, that is fourth option, only stands apart from whatever the statements are given. So out of all the given options, statement 1, 2 and 3 are correct. And so the answer for this question is option C, that is the statement 1, 2 and 3 are correct. In the next slide, we will see the last part of the MCQs. Question number 31. The supervisor can delegate his task to the following. The first one is a foreman. Second one is worker. Third is a colleague. And fourth is senior manager. And the options given are option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 1 and 3 only. Option C, 2 and 4 only. And option D, 1, 2 and 3. Now, first we should know what is the meaning of delegation. So delegation is nothing but giving some kind of authority. It is very important to note that the delegation is always from the top level management to the bottom level management. So whatever they have asked in the question, that is to whom the supervisor can delegate the task, then we have to consider what are the designation of the people in the given following statements. So in the first statement, we are having foreman, and foreman is the person who is the head for a particular group. So the supervisor can delegate any task to the foreman. The second statement is the worker. As worker will be having lowest designation supervisor can also allot any kind of authority or delegate the task to the worker. Then again, in the third statement, we are having colleague. Then again, supervisor can also delegate the task to the colleague. But in the fourth statement, we are having a senior manager. So as we know that a senior manager, he is the person from middle level management, and the delegation of any kind of task cannot be given from bottom level management to top level or middle level management. So this option will stand out, and the correct answer for this question will be foreman, worker and colleague. That is option D, 1, 2 and 3. Now let's see the next question. So the question is, good relations in a group helps to the following, and the options are option A, increase comfort level, option B, closeness, option C, friendship, and option D, only A is more correct. So in this question, we have to be more careful, as whatever the options that are given, all seems to be right. But out of four questions, we have to select only one option. So we have to think of each option carefully. The good relations in a group will definitely increase the comfort level. Good relations can also bring the people close to each other. And also with good relations, the friendship can also develop. Out of all these options, I will first tell you the answer. The correct answer for this question is option D. That is, only A is more correct. So for the given question, that is, good relations in a group, it will help to increase the comfort level. And now I will also tell the reason for this. Because whenever a supervisor forms a group in the industry or company, then the main reason behind this formation of group is to achieve the specific task or to complete the given project, and not to bring the people or the group members close to each other or develop the friendship among them. So here we have to focus on what is the outcome that we are going to receive or get from this good relations in a group. So though there might be closeness or friendships after the formation of this group, but our main objective is to increase the comfort level so that the job needs are satisfied and the expected outcome is obtained. Hence, the correct answer for this question is option D, that is, only A is more correct. Now again, the next question, question number 33. Supervisor organizes the following. We are having here five statements. First is man, second is machine, third is material, fourth is money, and five is work orders. So out of all these given statements, if we consider the first three statements, that is man, machine and material, so all are these resources. And we have already studied that the supervisor is always dealing with all such kind of resources for their effective utilization. If we speak about the fourth statement, that is money, then we know that there is no any direct connection of this resource, that is money, with the supervisor for handling in routine production activities. So this resource, that is money, that will be not organized by the supervisor. And the last statement, that is work orders. So work order is generally a task or job for a customer, and it is created either by the customer request or it can be created internally within the organization. And hence this fifth statement, that is work order, it cannot be considered as an activity for the supervisor. So the correct answer for this question is man, machine and material. That is option number C, only 1, 2 and 3. Now the last question from this chapter. The supervisor fails to plan if The four options they have given. Option A is not dynamic. Option B, he is not educated. Option C, he is not popular. And option D, he is not senior. The answer for this question, I will tell you directly, it is option A, that is, he is not dynamic. So for any plan to become successful, it is not necessary that the supervisor should be a senior, because nowadays if we look in some industries, then we can find out that many industries are having very young supervisors, and they are able to prepare very much super plans. On the other hand, we can also see some examples where the companies are having some senior supervisors, yet still they are having or facing several problems while working with the new product or technology. Then again, there is also no any requirement of education. So because experience is one such thing that we cannot buy even after paying a lot of money. Nowadays, if we look into the market, then due to increase in population, there is a lot of competition for the jobs. And for this purpose, whenever you are applying for a job, you will understand that the recruiters are not observing what all qualifications you are having, but instead they will try to find out what skills you have gained or whether you are good at the practicals or not. So along with this practical knowledge, it is necessary that the candidate or the person who is applying for the job, he should be dynamic, which is nothing but being always positive in attitude and full of energy with new ideas. So this is the current demand in the market, and this is also the answer for our question. So the supervisor will fail to plan if he is not dynamic, thus option A will be correct. So these were the questions from second chapter, that is planning and organizing at supervisory level. I hope that you will go through all these MCQs. So in total we have seen about 30 to 35 questions. Along with these questions, we will also take practice on Google Form. So I am actually planning for preparing the Google Forms with some of these MCQs, so that you will get idea regarding the format of paper which is taken by MSBT. This is very important, because for this particular subject you will not get any kind of sample papers or previous semester exam papers from MSBT, as just like the other subjects. From the website, for other subjects you will definitely get all the question papers along with the model answers. However, for this management subject, since the exam is conducted online for 70 marks, there is no any kind of question paper as well as its model answer on MSBT. So we are going to take some practice test for this subject with the help of Google Forms, where you can attempt these practice tests and also get your scores immediately after submitting the paper. So with this, we will stop here today, and very soon I will be sharing the links for the practice test. So till then, thank you very much.